So now let's look in a little more detail to what is an IDE. An IDE is a software application that supports software developers in many of their everyday tasks and has many useful features. Most IDEs provide views that can be used to navigate project resources from different perspectives. For example, you might want to look at your code differently when you're writing code and when you're debugging. They also normally provide an intelligent source code editor. For example, an editor that will allow you to browse the documentation when you're writing code that uses a specific method, or that will give you auto-completion when you start writing the name of an object and you want to get the methods for that object. And all of these things can be very useful while you're developing and can save you a lot of time. Modern IDEs will also normally give you support for version control systems that then you can use to do software configuration management. And we're going to discuss in detail version control systems in the next Tools of the Trade lesson. And we're also going to see how it can be integrated within an IDE. IDEs also give you builders, so they give you build automation tools. They give you runtime support, so that you can run your projects from within the IDE and, for example, observe some aspects of the execution. In addition to giving you support for the runtime, they give you support for testing. Many IDEs allow you to run tests from within the IDE and to check the results of the test from within the IDE. Not only that, normally after you run your tests, if there are some test cases that fail, you can also use your IDEs to do debugging. Many IDEs include graphical debuggers, debuggers that allow you to navigate through the code, set watchpoints, stop and restart the execution, inspect variables, and do all of the activities that help debugging and that help you being more efficient and more effective when you do debugging. And in addition to all these features that I listed here, IDEs can normally provide you even more features through a mechanism that is called plugins.